like to thank all of you for coming this morning to celebrate with us this occasion, to pay homage to our fallen brothers, which has dedicated the ultimate sacrifice. Their names are Ronald C. Hurst, Gus Stovall Jr., David L. Owens, Norman C. Ferris, and James C. Starnes. At this time, we will have open remarks by Commander Milton Jones, Commander of NAVFETS, Chapter 00102.
Part of the mission of the National Association for Black Veterans is to continue to highlight and amplify the contributions of African American and minorities to the military. This event is part of that mission. We not only want to honor the courage and contribution of these five men, but we also want to acknowledge the contribution of the 58,000 plus souls that were lost in Vietnam, as well as all of the individuals who have died in conflicts on behalf of their country.
Oh, can you see?
It was the Vietnam veteran that stepped forward and continues to step forward to make sure that our new veterans returning from Afghanistan and Iraq are properly thanked and respected. So with that, I salute you, Vietnam veteran, because you didn't have to do it. It wasn't done for you.
My father always said that, and he didn't talk much about his brother, but he always said that I reminded him of Ronnie. And I never got the opportunity to meet Ronnie, but one thing I do know is that those were some big shoes to fill, and that the expectations and the bar is set very high.
Vietnam is a war that continues to have victims, and I'm so happy that there are ceremonies like this that help with the healing and recognize what everybody went through when they were protecting our freedoms.
For the land of the free and the home of the...
You really have no idea how important this is to remember the sacrifices that these five individuals made for our community, and the legacy of what veterans have done since then.
Black soldiers who died in wars before were forgotten. Did you ever hear of black soldiers who fought the Indians for the Pilgrims, who died at Valley Forge, who turned the tide of the Battle of New Orleans, who were massacred in the Civil War, who led Teddy Roosevelt up San Juan Hill, who drew the praise of France in World War I, and who commanded tanks for George S. Patton? This is Wally Terry. For more than 2 years, I was in Vietnam with black soldiers of today. When they first came to Vietnam, they were anxious to prove themselves in the most integrated war in American history, sharing the leadership, sharing the foxholes, and sharing the plastic bags. Blacks account for only 11% of the American population, but in Vietnam, up to 22% of the dying.
One day, somebody said, "Hey man," because Gus Stovall was my neighbor, and somebody said, "Hey, did you hear about Gus Stovall?" I said, "What happened?" He said, "He got killed in Vietnam." I said, "What?" Wow. I said, "Oh my God. I mean, because, like I said, they were like family because they lived right across the fence from us, you know? So then all of a sudden, Ronnie Hurst got killed." I said, "Oh, yeah, that's right. Man." I said, "Dad, gone, two of them right almost beside each other." I said to myself, "Damn." I said, Somebody's got to do something. Because I said, years from now, people will be saying, Ronnie, remember the stuff that does monuments right next to Oak Grove? You'll go up Oak Grove, and there's a big monument place that does monuments and stuff like that. Headstones, monuments and stuff like that. Mm-hmm. And then in the meantime, while he was working on that, somebody else got killed over in Vietnam. Wow. Another brother named Owens. Yeah, that's who it was. Mm-hmm. Owens. And so we put his name on it. Before we know, we had five, six names on it.